Hi, I'm Randy Vance. Today I'm on Finseeker's 240 DC. Now this is a brand new boat from the company that brings you Crown Line boats. What we liked about this boat was its sleek lines and its massive wide open cockpit. I want to walk you through this boat and show you about some of the cruising family fun features and how well I think it's going to fish when you get aboard. Take a look at the design of this helm station. We've got a brow over the two Garmin displays. I love the way they've wired the Mercury engines into that to give you a great big dashboard display, both of your chart plotter and your engines. You can also break these screens up and show sonar as well. Now, Finseeker is using these flush switches. I like them because when you turn them on, they light up and you know that they're on. The other nice thing is they're easy to clean because they're not like the toggle switches sticking out. Now, they're all billeted, and even billeted trim goes around the trim tab switches. That's a really nice touch. Over here to the right of the wheel, you've got the electric switch to open the shore shade so that you can shade the entire cockpit of this boat. Down below, you've also got a windlass switch. Then all the way down, this is the electric hatch switch so that you can get into the bilge and service anything that needs service. Now you've got a three-spoke tilt wheel that's all vinyl wrapped. I love the steering knob here that really makes it easy when you're working around the dock. We've also got Mercury's electronic throttle and shift lever here. Your on-off switch is here, and you've got a throttle-only switch here, and I recommend pushing that anytime you leave the motor running and stepping away from the throttle. One thing I really appreciate about the build on this boat is this hard top. The stanchions are extra thick. It's very sturdy. Even the top itself is double-walled, and you can see on the edge, it's over a half an inch thick. That's a really solid system. Now with the sunshade on the aft, you've got the entire cockpit covered in shade, and that's great. Now when you stand in the cockpit of the 240 DC, you'd swear it's bigger than an 8.5-foot beam. There is so much space back here for fighting fish. You've got fold-out seats in the combings and in the transom. They snap away quickly and deploy easily so that when you're cruising out, everybody's got a comfortable place to sit. Over here on the port side, you've got a large live well that's got a fill, refill, and refresh setting. And I like the fact that it's also got an acrylic lid so that you can see inside it without lifting the lid. On the starboard side, you've got a door to the transom platform. This is where you're going to pull your big fish in. And when you do, lift the lids to the fish boxes right here in the floor. Guess what? They're macerated to pump overboard. Now each gunwale has a rod holder and there are two shotgun rod holders. In addition, you've got four rocket launchers and two kingfish rod holders for trolling. One thing I like that you don't see too often in a fish boat is the switch panel back here that runs everything you're going to want to use in the cockpit. So you don't have to go to the dash to do it. Your bait well, your cockpit lights, your raw water washdown, it's all available to turn on or off right here. The transom hatch opens up on an electric switch to give you access to your batteries, your pumps, and all the other things that might need service down the road. Another nice feature on the helm are these bucket seats. In particular, I like the fact that you've got the swivel lever and the slide fore and aft lever right here where you can reach it without crawling under the chair to find them. Now, in spite of the sleek style, they've managed to maintain that cockpit depth, and I really like that. So will parents of smaller children. There are grab rails there for safety, plenty of comfortable seating, and if the weather turns foul, you can close the cockpit off from the bow with this wind dam, and that's standard. Now, the Finseeker 240 DC is one of the best equipped boats on the water, and it's just packed full of standard features, not options. I love the way it'll entertain passengers with plenty of seating, plenty of comfort, and plenty of fishability. I'm Randy Vance on Finseeker's 240 DC.